Now, here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. Prime Minister Narendra Modi declaring victory for his alliance in India's general election despite his party losing seats to a stronger-than-expected opposition. According to ABC News, official results from India's Election Commission showed Modi's National Democratic Alliance won 286 seats. This is more than 272 needed to secure a majority, but far fewer than had been expected. This means Modi will still need the support of other parties in his coalition, a stunning blow for the 73-year-old who had hoped for a landslide victory. And in other foreign news, Google's chief privacy officer Keith Enright leaves the company after 13 years at the tech giant. Enright's departure is part of a broader reorganization within the privacy teams, with the company attempting to shift privacy policy to various individual product management teams. Still on tech, buyout firm Apollo Global Management set to acquire a 49% equity interest in Intel's manufacturing facility in Ireland for a whopping $11 billion. The deal, expected to close by the second quarter, would allow Intel to redeploy parts of its investment in the project to other parts of the business. More profitable, Intel has invested $18.4 billion in that facility, which is the U.S. chipmaker's first high-volume location for its Intel 4 manufacturing process. And some of the largest Chinese airlines reportedly buying more than 100 of Airbus's A330neo aircraft. Bloomberg reports the terms of the deal are still being discussed and the timing remains uncertain. The deal comes on the heels of a meeting between Chinese President Xi Jinping and his French counterpart Emmanuel Macron last month. Meanwhile, Tesla boss Elon Musk says they will likely spend $3 to $4 billion to purchase NVIDIA's hardware this year. This comes after Tesla reportedly told NVIDIA to prioritize shipments of AI processors to his company's X and XAI over the electric vehicle maker. And still with Elon Musk, his SpaceX receives a go-ahead from U.S. air safety regulators to launch its massive Starship rocket on a fourth major test flight. SpaceX now plans to launch the rocket as early as Thursday, June 6, from the company's launch facility in Texas. Starship is a key pillar of NASA's moon program that rivals China's moon ambitions. Canned sardine maker Mega Prime Foods eyeing more M&As focused on local brands to promote Philippine products and make them at par with global competitors. This after it added coffee to its portfolio by acquiring Gold Shine Pharmaceuticals' Jim's Coffee Mix, a Filipino coffee brand, for an undisclosed amount.
Really wanted to tap local brands that are out there to make sure that, you know, if you're having trouble, you know, dealing mm-hmm. with the multinationals mm-hmm. or the big brands out there, we're here to help. So we're here to either acquire or JV or be open for these local brands, local players, to really uplift what they have locally here. Mm-hmm. In terms of the pipeline, we have a lot of internal new products. That's our main thrust. It's really open for acquisition, mm-hmm. Open to help other local brands grow, mm-hmm. and organically developing new products for the Filipinos to enjoy.
The Philippine Land Transport Regulator mulls allowing unconsolidated jeepneys to keep operating for at least another year. Rizal Representative Jojo Garcia earlier suggested the move to give hesitant jeepney drivers and operators more time to see the benefits of the consolidation program. Supposedly, those who fail to meet the consolidation deadline will be considered colorum vehicles and will not be allowed to ply their routes. But to date, the LTFRB has yet to begin apprehending them. Government's POV modernization program has been met with opposition, with transport groups set to stage another protest action next week.
Sanay na po yung lahat ng agency. In fact, our commuters in Metro Manila, sanay na po sa kanilang plano. Siguro po yung pagsasabi lang, paglalabas lang naman po ng kanilang saloobin, we will give that right to them. Importante lang po, maging disiplinado tayo. Wala po tayong gagawing labag sa batas sakali.